What's going on, guys? So I just want to do a quick intro into this video and showing you this awesome recipe I made. It is a baked pumpkin spice cake oatmeal. The name is literally like as long as the macros are, but it turned out really well. And what I did differently this time is I split it up into two different cakes and I put the icing in the middle, and it turned out really well with this cake mix. Now, I haven't tried this before, but I've been considering it for quite a long time. So if you're looking for something really good, and it's actually pretty light, I ate this pre-workout, and usually I have to wait like an hour to an hour and a half before I hit the gym, but I could go to the gym in about a half hour after eating this because it just digested pretty fast. So check it out, and then we'll get into the rest of this video.
Everything costs something, bro. When it's somewhere, somewhere else, you just lost something, no. The cost of opportunities is always good to know. But if you know that, then you're good to go, yeah.
So breaking in this new gym with some deadlifts, and like 2 days prior to this workout, all I could think about was deadlifting on this platform because it was like one of the biggest selling points to this gym. And I think this is the first time you guys are seeing the inside, and you kind of can just tell it's like completely different atmosphere and setup than my previous gym. It's like old school, older plates, older equipment. It's kind of like that rundown feeling inside, but it's just like grungy. That's like the only way to describe it, grungy. But today's workout was a 3-rep scheme for deadlifts. I also did bench, but I didn't record that just because when I was benching, it was pretty busy. And I'm kind of just like getting in my rhythm in this gym and kind of feeling it out. Eventually, I'm going to film everything, but I'm kind of like trying to meet people and make friends before I start filming everything. So 500 for 3 reps on deadlifts felt really good today. And on bench, I was doing 290, and that felt easy. So next week, jumping up to 295 for 3 reps on bench. The only thing I don't like about this platform is it definitely has some wear and tear to it. It's definitely getting a little older. And like there are 6 plates there on the bottom, you can see, and they're kind of off balance. So you kind of like, I feel like I'm falling over a little bit when I'm deadlifting. And the bench they have here is really cool because it's like the one in Primal Training's videos where it has like a swing bar. I don't know what they're called, but it's like a swing bar where you rack the weight and you pull it over your chest when you're ready to start. And as soon as you lift the weight, that swing bar rolls back behind you. So it takes a lot of the pressure and all the strength out of your shoulders when you're lifting that bar up, so you can, you know, bench by yourself, and puts it all in your chest and just sets you up for, you know, pretty much success in a good position. And I really, really enjoy that one. And the weights here, you know, when you lift at a new gym, the weights always feel a little different, and I love the way these weights feel. It's kind of one of those like bodybuilder, powerlifter, you know, feels. And then this thing right here, man, that's just a bonus. That is just awesome and takes all the pain of unracking your weights. So I just got on lunch. I'm in this course for the Army right now, and it ends today, but it's been raining for like, I'd say 18 hours straight. Outside of my apartment, we have like a little runoff, and it's like 4 feet deep of water. But today's Thursday, and on Thursday at Fort Hood, post actually closes down 2 hours early, so it ends at 3 today. So I was gonna take off today from the gym, but I figured if I have the time, I'm gonna go to the gym, make some food, take the dog for a walk, and then I'll take tomorrow off in preparation for a very anticipated video that's coming out. It's been a very highly requested one, so try to guess it in the comment section below, but you guys will be happy about this one. So that's what's going on there. I'm also thinking about getting a new tattoo to add on to this one right here. So this one, that's for my grandparents, because my one set of grandparents growing up were like the most supportive people ever. Went to every single sporting event of me and my brothers. They traveled like hours to make it. Went with them to church every Sunday. We always had like family dinners and lunches with them. And now that they're older, they're living in assisted living. They had moved like recently, like a year ago. So they're not doing as good as they did. And you know, my grandpa just recently, in the last 2 years, got cancer too. So I got this tattoo for them. So I was actually born on their anniversary, which is really crazy. August 1st is my birthday. And since I was born on their anniversary, I got 8-1 August 1st in Roman numerals and a rose for each of them. So I kind of want to add on to that one. And I have like an idea of what I want, and maybe I'll even do a video while I get this tattoo. But I've been wanting to get this idea for the last couple months now, just haven't really found a time to get it. So I think one of these weekends coming up, I'm going to schedule something, go do it, we'll film it, and we'll see how it turns out. But down here in Austin, I mean, Austin's like kind of hipsterish, so I'm sure I can get a very, very high quality tattoo. Because, you know, any big city, there's really good tattoo shops. So I'm gonna go finish up this course right now, take this test, get my certificate, go home, and there's something I wanna talk about. So a while ago, I was on Instagram and I saw this recipe that I've been wanting to try for a long time. And it was just like French toast, but it was a banana cut into pieces, then wrapped in bread, and then just like made into French toast. But I was always intimidated by it because it looked like one of those recipes that, you know, on Instagram looks really good and probably tastes really good, but then in reality, it just turns into a mess. But on camera, I'm gonna make it and we'll see how it turns out. So I'm just using two bananas. Then we use four slices of this bread. Per slice of this bread, it's only 11 grams of carbs. And then this mixture is one egg, probably about a quarter cup of almond milk, some cinnamon, and then a tablespoon of Splenda. So I'm gonna just like cut these up, flatten the bread and roll it in the banana, dip it in this, and then come over here and put it in this pan. I just bought these pans and I got them at, I think, Ross or like TJ Maxx or something. And like the first time I used them, they like are burnt and brown and stuff. I mean, they're good pans, it's just they look like crap already. It's a lot easier if you just eat them with your hands than with a fork, but. That's good. So I am mixing out my pre-workout right now, hitting the gym, doing shoulders and arms tonight. I'm gonna film it, but I'm not gonna include it in this video. I'll include it in another one, maybe tomorrow, because tomorrow's my off day. So I'll try to put a video out tomorrow night, as well as Saturday, the big surprise Saturday, see what's coming out. But in the meantime of doing this, I'm also trying to rescue a cat that my dog chased up a tree. So we have this neighbor cat that just sits out in front of our house or apartment, just waiting for Leroy to come outside. And as soon as the dog goes outside, the cat runs up the tree and it stays up there all night. And I feel bad whoever owns that dog or that cat, because they probably hate me. Another topic to discuss, what I wanted to bring up actually, this book that I recently read. And I'm really not a big reader. I rarely ever read books. And I can probably on the one hand tell you how many books I read front to back. It's not many. And like two of those are probably mandatory military reading books. But like this book, Creative Confidence by Tom Kelly, Unleashing the Creative Potential Within Us All. And it was actually really good. I was like in a Barnes and Nobles and it was like one of those books that was on the side and like you guys probably heard me talk about before, impulse buy. I was like, oh, it sounds pretty good. So I picked it up and it talks about like a lot of people think that you're either born creative or you're not born creative. And I think this is something that I used to like kind of think that held me back from a lot of things. And then I kind of started this YouTube channel and then editing videos and shooting videos made me think maybe I have some more creativity than I really thought. And I think a lot of people are in that position or in those shoes where you don't realize your potential until you like understand how to really like grasp it and use it. So I mean, my like channel, I guess, was YouTube, a YouTube channel where I was able to like realize I have some creativity in me. And now I'm taking that next leap and I think I'm gonna take singing lessons. I've always wanted to sing. And I was doing research on like online singing lessons and I think it's something I might do. What do you guys think? By the tone of my voice, do you think I could be a singer? Let me know. But hit the gym, wrapping up this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope you have a great week and weekend. And remember, look forward to Saturday's video.